If I have to show you the entire changes, it's actually a big tabular column. Okay, so what I have done is I made this a tabular column so it is easier for you to remember when you're doing the revisions. So I have mentioned the type of cells, how the features, how it looks, what are the condition it looks, and what are the shapes. So one by one, if you have to see, first is spherocytosis. Spherocytosis, in this you will have a spheroidal shape of cell. It looks like a spear. Okay, so it looks like a spear, hemisphere, spear, it looks like a spear. So these are seen in hereditary spherocytosis. It's in the name itself, hereditary spherocytosis. It is seen in hemolytic anemia. It is also seen in newborns. Okay, hemolytic disorder of the newborn. Okay, then cystocytosis. Cystocytosis, this means there is fragmentation of red blood cells. Fragments means these are broken parts. Okay, these are seen in thalassemia, in megaloblastic anemia, iron deficiency anemia. Okay, the next is your irregularly contracted red cells. The name itself means the feature. So you have irregularly shaped RBCs. These are seen in drug use or chemical induced hemolytic anemia. Then we have something called leptocytosis. Leptocytosis are thin red cells. They are very thin red cells. One example of leptocytosis is target cells. These are central round body stained area with a peripheral rim of hemoglobin. Okay, so these target cells, you know what targets, when you throw arrows, this is how the target looks like. No? If you aim in the center, you get high point. When you go outside, you get less points. So target. So this is a target shape cell. This is seen in iron deficiency anemia, thalassemia, chronic liver disease, and after splenectomy. Next, sickle cells. Sickle cell means it's sickle shape. This you must have seen while farming when they have to cut the grass. So sickle shape. Okay. So these are seen as sickle cell disease. Then crenated red cells. Crenated red cells means there are a lot of spikes. Okay. There are a lot of spikes. So this is known as crenated red cells. Crenated red cells are seen due to any defect by the lab technician. This happens when we are not doing the test properly. What happens if the blood films that we are doing has a lot of alkaline pH, or there is fatty substance left in the slides which was not cleaned properly, or we have left the slides outside overnight for a very long time. So because of our negligence, we can see this crenated red cells. Okay, other one is acanthocytosis. Acanthocytosis is also a crenated red cell. There are still projections you can see. These projections are seen in splenectomized patients, means after splenectomy, in chronic liver disease. Burr cells. Burr cells means cell fragments having one or more spines. So you have these spines. These are projections. Spine means bigger projections. Okay, so these are spines. This is seen in uremia. Okay? Stomatocytosis. Stomatocytosis means presence of stomatocytes. What are these stomatocytes? They look like mouth. See, mouth. You have an opening. So this mouth-like presence is seen in alcoholism and in hereditary stomatocytosis. Okay, ovalocytosis. Ovalocytosis means oval shaped cells. These are seen in hereditary ovalocytosis. Just add hereditary in front of ovalocytosis. It is also seen in megaloblastic anemia and hypochromic anemia. Okay, so we are finished with the different types of cells that we can see. Now, red cell indices. Remember red cell indices. In red cell indices, what do we see? I've given you examples over here of in cases where there is reduced red cell indices are your MCV, MCH, MCHC. Okay. So these indices, if in case they reduce, you can see these in iron deficiency anemia and thalassemia. If they are normal, what are the cases you can see? And if they have increased, if they have increased. Okay, so this is your reduced, this is normal, and this is increased. It is reduced in cases of iron deficiency anemia and thalassemia. Okay, and normal. Normally it is seen in When anemia due to acute blood loss, means you have an accident. In acute blood loss, if you have anemia, then these values are normal. They don't have a lot of changes. They're still within normal limit. Okay? Then these will increase higher in case of megaloblastic anemia. Okay? So I made, rather than words, these are easier to remember. Just remember these three tables. Okay? Then leukocytes. Leukocytes are WBCs and platelet counts. Now why we have to measure these? We have to measure these to differentiate anemia from other type of diseases like pancytopenia. In pancytopenia, what happens? Everything is increased. Everything is decreased. What are they? RBCs are also decreased, WBCs are also decreased, and platelets are also decreased. So to differentiate between anemia and anemia, what happens? Only there are problems in the RBCs. WBCs and platelets are normal, but in pancytopenia, everything is abnormal. So I've just given. So what happens is in anemia. So I've given you that where you can see this and what happens in anemia due to hemolysis or hemorrhage. Neutrophil counts and the platelet counts are often elevated. So these are your features and where it is seen. Okay. So in anemia due to hemolysis, you can see neutrophil counts and platelet counts are often elevated. There is increase. In infection in leukemias, the leukocyte counts are high and immature leukocytes are seen in the blood. So why? Because of infection, the body is different, will have to fight. So in this body's defense are your WBCs. So a lot of WBCs will come to fight against all the infections or against the cancer cells. Because of that, what happens? Because you need more, the body will produce a lot of cells and most of them will be immature. So because of that, you have immature leukocytes in the blood. Okay? Then reticulocyte counts. Reticulocyte count. Normally in our body, we can see some amount of normal reticulocyte count. But if in case these increases, then that is known as reticulocytosis. Okay? So, what happens is when reticulocyte is done to see how the bone marrow's erythropoietic activity can be seen when we do reticulocyte count. In acute hemorrhage and in hemolysis, reticulocyte count will help us to know if the bone marrow is impaired or not. Okay. If in case you had an accident. After the accident, if you check the blood flow, if you see a lot of reticulocyte, this means that the patient is going to lose even more lot of blood because the bone marrow is not making proper blood cells. It is making only reticulocyte. So what will happen? The body will have less hemoglobin and less oxygen carrying capacity. Okay, so these are very important factors that we have to check. So these are the reticulocytes that we check. So reticulocytes, you will have these organelles. Blood cells, you will not see these organelles. Okay, so these are organelles in reticulocyte. So how these reticulocytes have become important? When you have anemia will stimulate the erythropoietin from the kidney. This erythropoietin that is formed. If there is hemorrhage, now this hemorrhage will also increase hematopoietin. Because of the increase of hematopoietin, what happens? There is increase in reticulocytes. These reticulocytes will remain in the bone marrow for 2 to 3 days. But after that, they'll have to come out to blood vessels. And when they come out to blood vessels, they have to become red blood cells. If they don't become red blood cells and continue to be reticulocytes, that is the problem that we are going to face. Of reticulocytosis. So when anemia is there, anemia will stimulate erythropoietin. If there is hemorrhage, that will also stimulate erythropoietin. Because of this, you will have increased reticulocyte formation. This reticulocyte formation, 2 to 3 days, it will stay. It will peak. It will come to a stable plateau at 6 to 10 days, and this particular peak will be there. This particular peak will be there till 6 to 10 days. Sorry, I like to explain this once again. What happens is, when you have anemia and also hemorrhage, so there is increase in your reticulocyte. Okay, this peak, this increase happens in 2 to 3 days. But it reaches the peak at 6 to 10 days. And it will stay like this for a very long time. So that is why you have a lot of reticulocytes. Okay, now erythrocyte sedimentation rate. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate is a very non-specific test. It is not only done for hemoglobin estimation is done for a lot of other factors also. Okay, so what happens? We take blood, we make the blood sit for 60 minutes. After that, what happens? The blood will differentiate into plasma, buffy coat, and red blood cells. So, what are the factors in which there is increased ESR and decreased ESR? ESR is increased during pregnancy, anemia, inflammatory disease, in case of rheumatic fever, rheumatic arthritis, anemia, and tuberculosis. And it is decreased in case of sickle cell anemia, spherocytosis, microcytosis. Okay? And lastly is the bone marrow examination. Bone marrow aspiration is done in case of anemia. This was already discussed in the previous class. You can go refer to the previous points. So the two procedures are your marrow aspiration and trephine biopsy. Okay. So students, we have finished the introduction to anemia. Okay. So next will be the classification of anemia. Thank you.